Good morning, children. Today we will revise the chapter Changes in Transport System. Transport has played an integral part in our life. From early days, when it was not so developed, when it was not so modernized, from then people used to travel from one place to another with the use of animals, and then slowly, gradually, they have invented wheels, and then the transport system has taken place. Now, mainly transport system can be divided into three categories. One is land transport, the other one is water transport, and next one is air transport. Among them, air transport is the fastest means of transport. In a very short period of time, you can go from one place to another through air transport. Land transport is the very common way means of transport. In between, land transport can be again broadly divided into two parts, that is roadways and the railways. Roadways connect the villages, towns and cities through the roads, highways, expressways. Roads are also divided into four categories. There are the village roads, then super highways, expressways, district roads. So they are divided to connect from one place to another. And roadways are also the cheaper means of transport, and it also connect from one place to another, and it can go in a very short period of time. Now, what are the examples of land transport? That is road transport, buses, cars. You can use bicycles also, even bullock carts in villages. You can see tractors, they are used in villages. And in cities, you can see vehicles like buses, cars, vans, then you can see bike, two-wheelers also, four-wheelers also. And the railways are having many categories, like from in between the cities, major cities like Kolkata, Chennai, Delhi, Mumbai. In between the cities, if people want to travel from one place to another, and the daily passengers who work, so local passengers who work from one place to another, and they want to travel in between the cities, they used to travel in metros. And the local trains, which is used in Kolkata to go from one place to another, they are known as trams. Then some are the super express trains, like Rajdhani train, then Shatabdi train. They are having the super fast train because they can travel from one place to another in a very short period of time. The bullet trains now being introduced in our country, they are the super fast express train, and they will work on the elevators. Magnetic field, they will work on the magnetic field. Others are toy trains. In hill stations, we can see the small trains usually used to travel for the tourist people. They are known as toy trains. Now come to water transport. Water transport also can be divided into two parts, that is inland waterways and the international waterways. The ships, big ships, they travel from one country to another country. They carry goods also, even people also, passengers also. And small inland waterways also, from one place to another, through rivers, by steamers, boats, from one place to another, goods and people are transported from one place to another. So they are known as inland transport system. Now air transport is also can be divided into two parts, that is one is domestic airways, another one is international airways. Domestic means within the country, if you want to go from one place to another, you can avail. For water transport, harbors are there, ports are there. For railways, railway stations are there, where the halting position of the vehicles. Roadways, you are having the bus stoppage. And for air transport, we are having the airports. So domestic airports, if a person wants to go from Mumbai to Delhi, so they will use the domestic airlines. And if a person wants to go from India to USA, they will use the international airways. So our major international airports are in Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai, then Mumbai. Okay, so each are having their different names, like Delhi is Indira Gandhi International Airport, Kolkata is Netaji Subhash Chandra International Airport, Mumbai is Chhatrapati Shivaji International Airport. Then Tiruvannam International Airport. There are many international airports are there. Even along with the aeroplanes, helicopters are also used. They are mainly used to rescue and are used where aeroplanes cannot land. The place where aeroplanes cannot land, and they have the advantage to fly in a fixed place, and they can fly over a certain height. Aeroplanes cannot go everywhere because it is the size of the aeroplanes are big and helicopters are smaller than them, and for rescuing, for natural calamities, if any happening in throughout the country, that time government uses helicopter to rescue people from these natural calamities. I hope you have understood the chapter. Thank you.